Give me one moment. Well, I feel as though that has been one moment. So I can proceed. But we shall see. I don't like to make predetermined assumptions. So I suppose we best begin with your cross section of your flat section. That is fascinating. Which then completes the idea of a cross section. Just a line, really, but with this, that is quite common for that. So now we go for our intervals of our cross sections. That's not really level, but about there, yes. Yes, notes to there, and that to there. See, now we do our other interval. Sorry, I thought something touched my foot. It's always quite a concerning thing when that happens. So that is our second interval for your two-dimensional cross section. But now let's, yes, this one's a little bit more difficult. Let's go for a second and third. Second interval. Yes. Of course, we could do substantially more of these, but we probably won't. There's not much point, as your face isn't two-dimensional anyway. That wind is suddenly rattling those wind chimes. I'm sure it's even, but I do like to make sure. Procedure, it always seems to be ever so blustery. I don't know what that's about. Perhaps you just bring the bad weather with you. Yes. So I have a good dimension of you. Now, I must take note of my findings, because I will forget, especially that second interval. Yes. Just one moment. Well, that has been another moment. Let me see. Now I'm going to do that first. A second. Second interval. This would be so much easier if I could spell. Oops. Aren't D's funny to write? They're like a little round thing and it goes up and round, or round and up, really. It's sort of back to front roller coaster. Yes, and then we had the first or the second interval. The second of the first, and then it'll be the first of the first. You know, I shouldn't blame the wind. I should just say I live by the ocean, and then people would think that I am rich with a nice seaside manor. I don't really like the ocean, I won't lie. Then the standard cross section, I can just draw that with some arrows. And then let's get another arrow here. So those are my findings so far. Oh dear, that is cutting off my circulation. That is quite the predicament. Well, that's as far as that sleeve's going. Now, where's... Now. As we are dealing with this third dimension, we need to... some more. There we are. wind is ever so persistent. Seems to be that for your third dimension. Now just give me one moment to just These are some fascinating finds. Should I? No, I won't note your third dimension yet. I'm not quite done. Instead of a seaside manor, I could just be on a boat or something instead. I suppose that would be equal. It does sound like a much more of a fierce mid-ocean rather than a shoreline. So I feel that is your two dimension and your three dimension, your contours for the overall shape. But none of the details yet. No, it's just a shape. Now we do the details. Bring each one down. Just rearrange my feet. That is that detail measured. And let's just do this. And then I can itemize as I please. And now we itemize. Let me just do a little section by section here. Yes, once again, we are measuring these features as two dimensions. I will, of course, because this tape measure can bend, I will then measure, you know, the depth of things as well. But first, we just get that second dimension before we confuse things. Around to your side details. Just this side detail. I suppose if I just let that hang, if I take note of these new two-dimensional findings and the previous three-dimensional findings for your complete shape, then I can do the third dimension for your details. And then we'll be done. Yes. Just give me one moment. It's crazy how quickly a moment can pass. Now with this is the third dimension for your overall now your two dimension for your details. In this column can be for your details. let me collect the data for your third dimension, for your details. You'll notice I'll be doing a demand of this for the sort of scalloped recesses. Are incorrect, then that kind of makes the whole thing redundant. Isn't it funny how that looks? It's all just that a bit of light that's just like bloop, bloop, bloop. So I've stopped doing it as soon as I was trying to demonstrate. Sometimes the contours for that side. Now let's do the contours. I'm just moving my feet. Now let's do the contours for this side. And that looks like the recess for that side. So, oh, your under recess. How could I forget the one that connects from here to the protruding here? thing is just the third dimension for your side details, and then we are done. Because I may need just a moment to finalize my findings, but that shan't take but a moment. Rearranging my feet quite a lot, but it's all about angles. Now, rearrange my feet again, and now we're doing this. I really like it when my left hand has to lead. I am very right-handed. Dimension details. So, that brings us to the end. I have recorded my findings. So, I hope you take care, and I hope to see you sometime soon.